According to Robert Abia, the Masindi Deputy Chief Administrative Officer, 2.8 billion shillings was returned, 1.92 billion shillings was meant for salaries, pension 155 million shillings, gratuity 396.3 million shillings, and capital development project 1.96 billion shillings, among others.
Delay of the hybrid procurement process of the secondary schools, it affected the project timeline for the implementation of construction of the city secondary school, and the mismatch in the records for the beneficiaries of the gratuity. So that led to the return back of the money in the consolidated fund. However, with the projects under your gift, we have written to the ministry for purposes of voting to ensure that the project execution continues.
Abia highlighted why the education sector was the most affected department.
The resources that were returned back to the consolidated account for government in central government, the departments that are mostly affected was education. The reason being that this money was voted late, and it came for the construction of Seed Secondary School, specifically the secondary school of Kijunjuga and then St. Paul Pakanya. So specifically it means that it is that those two projects that resources went back under a scheme called U-Gift.
Pamela Nyakato, the Secretary for Finance at Masindi District Local Government, faulted the Finance Ministry for sending the money extremely late. This was towards the end of a financial year, adding that they could not utilize the money in the shortest time possible.
A particular item cannot be used for any other thing except that very item. So if you don't use it for that very item, it means this money has to go back. So this money went back. We had the gratuity money. This came about because of the delay in processing the files. It is a process from the time you identify someone until the time of this app.
The district chairperson, Biaruhanga Cosmas, blamed the District Service Commission for the return of 1.92 billion shillings, pointing out a number of loopholes.
In 2021-2022, we have returned a total of about 2.8 billion, and this is arising from the salary, which is about 1 billion, and then also the capital development, which is about 1.2 billion. And this is because we could not do much with the salary. We have had challenges with the recruitment. Last financial year, we attempted to recruit, but IGG withheld the results. This financial year, we have tried to recruit. We have not been very successful.
About 2.8 billion to the treasury, just because of a few things. One, we did not do the recruitment because some part of the money has gone, was for wage, which we have not made the recruitment of recent. We've been having a lot of scuffles and challenges in the service commission. So by all means, we could not fill all the vacant positions because of the fracas in the district service commission.
Story by Joseph Pakuma for the news in Masindi District.